Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And we have David and Christine Waite here, and also Lila Shutt. Is that how you say it?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And they are just back from Massachusetts. They went out there, and they were just seeing people healed right and left. I do have to make one announcement first, though. In the last weekend in January, we're going to be in Ankeny doing a DHT. And check out the website for the addresses. And where we're going to be is going to be in a center. And we're actually going to start having our church there. So that's just new. And so I just wanted to make that announcement. So it won't be in our home any longer. We're going to have it there at the center. On Sunday morning, yes. During the week when we have Tuesday night and Saturday night, we'll still do that out of our home. But the Sunday morning service we're going to be doing there. So praise God.
Mm-hmm.
So he kind of gave us that idea. It took me a while to figure it out. He said the high school. And the Ankeny High School, I checked into it, and they didn't have any rooms available. Well, after we went to check this building out, I noticed that on the outside of the building, it said it was the high school. It was the old high school. old high school that Norma went to.
Wow.
So I just missed the obvious sometimes. So we're looking forward to that. It's going to be good. So tell us what happened. Well, you wanted to start with the person that was in the coma. So tell us what happened there, Lila.
We went to Massachusetts to a timeshare that Dave and Christine own. Mm-hmm. And they went to a meeting, and they tried to sell them something more. And the guy that was talking to them said, well, you know, I really don't care if you buy anything today or not. He goes, because my dad is in a coma in the hospital.
Oh.
So we feel it's a divine appointment.
Yeah.
And so we went there to the, and he says, well, we're ministers. Can we go pray for your dad? And Christine and Dave asked him that, and he said, yes. And so we found out the address of the town that he was in the hospital. And just before we got there, he went to ICU.
Mm-hmm.
CCU,
critical care unit. Yes.
Yeah.
And so, of course, the devil was working overtime. But, you know, he can't win.
Amen.
And so we went to the hospital, and we prayed for him, and he had tubes in his mouth, and he had, we were praying for him, and we thought he was going to actually jump out of the bed.
Oh.
Because he was going like this with his mouth, like he's going to talk.
Uh-huh.
And then next thing you know, they only gave us 5 minutes. And so the next thing you know, I was laying my hands on his legs, and his legs started moving, and I thought, boy, is he going to jump up, walk, talk? What's he going to do? And so the next day, well, I said, no, we got to find out what the report is on this guy after we prayed. So I laid hands on him, prayed. And we found out by this son, the next day when he went to work, his dad is out of the coma, he's sitting up, and he's talking.
All right.
Praise God.
Praise God. That is so cool. Isn't that exciting?
That was exciting. That was
really exciting. Neat. We love to hear stuff like that. God is so good.
Yeah.
So what else do you guys have?
We found out, you know, there's a lot of desperate people out there now because MRSA and these serious bugs, the bacteria that they're getting in the hospitals, are killing people.
Oh, wow.
And while we were there, Lila was like, we're not done yet. It wasn't enough to get somebody out of a coma. She said, there's a family over here. And obviously they're here because somebody's in the critical care unit, and we really need to just go pray for them. So we walked over there, and we asked them a question, and they said, yeah, their sister, who's 50-something years old, had gone in only for sciatic pain, and she got MRSA, and the bacteria took over, and her kidneys were failing, and she was in CCU dying.
Oh, my God.
And the whole family was like, this can't be real. You know, how can that happen? It was sciatic pain. She's not supposed to be dying, and her kidneys aren't supposed to be failing.
Oh, wow.
And so we sat down with them, all three of us, and joined hands. The whole room was in tears. And we said, we're not going to pray. Why don't you tell what you said to them? Because I just thought that was awesome.
Well, something, I don't know if it was something they said or what, but it led me to believe that they were Catholics, and I think they were. And I said, we're not going to pray like you would probably normally think prayer is. We believe what Jesus did was the way to pray, and he laid hands, okay, and he commanded. So what we're going to do is we're going to command the sickness. to go.
Amen.
And so we started to pray, and we're just commanding away. And the next thing you know, they're all, everybody's in tears. I mean, they're just bawling their eyes out. And so we're just, you know, we didn't pull our faith back. We just believed that her, I believe her name was what, Betty or something like that, that yes. she was healed.
Amen. You know?
So we had really had some exciting times. For me, what was exciting, probably the most exciting thing was a good friend of ours, Charlie, who was a pastor at a church that we were at when we were back in Massachusetts, he is 93 years old, and he is just, I mean, at 93, you would not believe that he's 93. He is a spitfire when it comes to having energy and everything else. And we sat there. We went to visit him because we heard his wife had cancer. Mm-hmm. And so anyways, we sat there talking to him, and I was ministering to him in the Word and just, you know, telling him how Jesus is the standard by which we have to measure everything. And he got so excited. He knew about John Lake years ago. Mm-hmm. He never really followed through with it. And what was really exciting is that we get a call on the way back. We were in Iowa someplace in the middle of almost being blown off the road from the winds. And he calls, and Chris took the phone, and he's on his, at this point in time, he's telling us he's on his third day of the DHT listening to Curry Blake, and he says, this man is absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah. Amen.
So he's excited. He wants to get certified, and he wants us to come back and do a DHT out
Amen.
There. So
and he's already asking about all of the connections we know. Oh, I think this house, they'll open their house and we'll be able to teach over there. And then we'll do this and we'll do that. I mean, he's 93 and he's
wow.
not retired. He's not going to retire from Christ. Do you know what I'm saying?
Praise
there is
God.
No retirement in Christ. You just keep going. And
yeah.
you don't stop learning. And he's so excited about what he's learning. And he said, you know, I went out to hslm.us, and I clicked on everything I could click on. I looked at everything on their site. And I heard the testimonies. And I saw all that stuff. And she said, and then that led me to Curry Blake. And did you know that his DHT is on his site too? And you can go out there and hear all of them. And he was so, I said, oh, wow, wait till you finish that. Then we'll get you on the New Man series. Then we'll get you on the SWAT. And before you know it,
Amen.
You know, he can yeah. be running his own meetings and his life group in his house.
Good.
Yeah.
Praise God.
We also went back to the church that we came from.
Uh-huh.
And there's a whole bunch of people that are excited about us going out there to do a DHT there. And in fact, the assistant pastor, Pastor Vi, she announced us from the pulpit that we would be coming back to do a training with them.
Praise God.
Yeah.
So it's pretty exciting, a lot of the stuff that we went through. We had a lunch with them afterwards and got some of the people healed and set free there. And
Amen.
So it was a pretty exciting time.
And we killed a few sacred cows because it's one of our favorite things to do.
Roasting the beef.
Oh, good.
I've been looking for one of them trailers where I can put one of them old fuel barrels on and paint it bright red like sacred cow cooker.
We need to get one of those old cow statues and put flames up on it
yeah,
around the sides.
Really.
And it gets burning.
Amen.
So we also went to see a friend of ours, Mary Beth and Michael Goneman. And, you know, it's really hard when you see someone who's strong in their faith and has been a warrior and someone who's been praying and all their life has known the power of God and has been delivered from witchcraft and all kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
And she was so beat up, you know, just beat up. There's a lot of saints out there just beat up and weary from the enemy.
Yeah.
And so about a year ago, she almost died. She believed she was dead. Her husband found her laying in the bathroom with her eyes rolled up into the back of her head. And he said, you weren't there, Mary Beth. When I went in there to pray for you, you were not there. And he brought her back. But in that year, she just felt like she has nothing left, like she's been evaporated.
Oh.
And so we went after that.
Good.
And she had been in bed for a day or two, fever, sick, everything. And it was just hard to really see her in that state because we're so energized and excited and all that stuff. And it's like, okay, we need to give you what we have.
Amen.
And we did. We blasted her.
Yeah, she had pain in her knees, pain in her hips, a whole bunch of things. When we were done, the pain in her knees was gone. The pain in her hips was gone. She was more energized. You could see her spirit was more up. There was just a radical transformation.
She went from that pale gray to having color in her face.
Yeah.
Just in no time at all, as we prayed for her. And then we talked and we shared the things that we're learning and the sacred cows that we've killed. And she's understanding, you know, that this really is a truth you need to get a hold of, and you got to do it fast because the enemy won't keep beating you up.
Yeah.
You'll just have some freedom from all of that.
Yeah.
And so we were hoping we could do a DHT while we're out there, and then the blizzard came into town. And, you know, 2 days of that, and nobody was going anywhere.
Tell them about Christopher.
Oh. So as Mary Beth's father was getting prayed for, Christopher's father, I was praying for him, as I usually do, and he was just watching everything because
And he's smart.
He's really sharp. But he's looking up, and he's paying attention, but he's not happy because he's not involved. So he walked over, and he put his elbow up so it would be under my hand while I was praying. He wanted my hand to be on him. And so I said, well, now I know he's open. I'll lay my hand on his head. And I did, and I prayed. And then I turned to him, and I said, Christopher, you have some amazing things to do for the kingdom. Jesus is so alive in you, and he loves you so much. And you know what? You have the power to do something right now. Would you like to? And he said, yes. I said, you can put energy from God into your mom. Mm-hmm. You can go pray life for her. Did you know that? And he's okay. He ran around the table, and he went on the other side, and he laid hands. I said, repeat after me. And he did. He said, in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. And he went, life. Like, he got it.
She got blasted.
She's got
absolutely
in the chair.
She's sitting in the chair going,
it was amazing. Awesome. And she was so touched because he's adopted. She had waited for so long to have more children. She has a daughter, and she waited for so long to have a child. And she adopted him from Florida, and she knows he's a treasure. And
how
she
old
knows.
Is he?
Oh, gosh.
Just guess.
Six-ish.
Oh, okay. Cool. That's neat. Such a young age to get it.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Yeah, we love to teach people to do it, you know, wherever we go. And it's just amazing. We had John the other night. He comes every once in a while, and he's starting to come a little bit more. And New Year's Eve he came. And God had me do this. I just put my hand on him, and I said, I just charge you to do the work of the Lord, what God wants you to do. And I said, I just speak holy boldness into you right now. And, oh, my gosh, he was just shaking and baking and just he didn't know what to think. God was just doing a mighty thing in him, and it was so neat. And I think that was New Year's Eve, so that was like Tuesday. And then Sunday morning, he was there for church, and there was a lady that needed prayer, or maybe it was Saturday night, one or the other. Anyhow, he laid his hands on her, prayed for her, and he actually really blasted her this time.
Yeah.
I felt the power of God when he prayed, and he's just so shy that he hadn't done that previously. And we've known him for what, 4 years? Really that long? Wow.
Yeah, because we
the open Bible.
Oh, wow. Because he just come every once in a while.
I met him at the first DHT.
Okay.
And I remember praying for him then.
Oh, not John Morris, John Gurley.
Oh, it's not.
No.
Okay.
So, but he just really, really got it. And Dave says, you're such a thinker, you know. Some people that think really hard, they think they got to figure it out. And you can't quite figure out everything when it comes to God. So it was just really neat to see how God really got through. You know, he just broke through that thinking thing. And it was just so neat to see him walking in it, you know?
Well, I think Lila would be able to share what happened when we decided to go clothes shopping at the mall.
Okay, cool.
Oh, yeah. What was the kid's name?
Owen.
So we're going shopping, and this young man, he's a black man, and we're talking to him about God, and he said, well, my father is actually a pastor. And for some reason, Christine got the wrong skirt size. So we had to go back to get the right skirt size. And now we know why that happened. Because they had, when we got back, Owen was there, and not only Owen, but his uncle was there. Uh-huh. And his uncle had told us a story about his life where he used to know the Lord and he fell away, and now he's trying to get back with the Lord. And so we were talking about all these things about Curry Blake, and they go, well, now, don't forget me. He says, I want to be included in this. So Christine says, well, when we come back and have a DHT, well, we'll include you. Don't worry. And she told him to go to what chapter was it? Ezekiel.
So we started talking to them about the thing that I love to kill, my most favorite cow to kill, is generational curses. And I'm amazed how many people just believe they're still under generational curses. Uh-huh. And so I said, there are nuggets in there that are going to bless your heart and set you free in ways you don't understand. I mm-hmm. said, for instance, generational curses are no more. And he said, where's that? Where's that in the Bible? And so I looked it up on my phone. He even told me, you can Google it, right? And I said, oh, yeah, let me do that on my phone right now. So I looked it up and I said, okay, so in Deuteronomy 28, it talks about the curses. But when you go further into Ezekiel in chapter
18,
it's either 12 or 18. Anyway, I said, it's like verse 2. It starts to tell you about the fathers biting into a sour grape and the son's teeth being set on edge, and how this is a proverb you will no longer say, because that's just not, it's not accurate anymore. God says every man stands before him on their own merits for whatever they have done, and the Amen. Father's stuff isn't accounted to them. And so the son is getting all excited, and they're both his uncle Michael. And I was like, you mean like Michael, like the archangel Michael, right? I said, wow. I said, you want to see the resurrection power of God, don't you? And his eyes got all big. And so I said, we're going to come back and we're going to do a teaching. And the son said, I will go. I will definitely go. And that's what Michael said. Well, don't leave me out. Don't leave me out of that. So, and he's on the phone. When I walked in, he was on the phone. Owen was on the phone. And he goes, Dad, that lady I was telling you about, she's in my store right now. You need to talk to her. And he hands me to his father.
Oh, my gosh.
Who's a pastor. And I said, hello, man of God. I understand you're working for the kingdom, as am I. And I just want to let you know, your son is an anointed man of God. He has a calling on his life to reach the youth. I said, the people that are his age, I see him ministering to people his own age and telling them the things that he's learning so that they can have someone as a hero to look up to.
Amen.
The youth today don't know who to anchor to because there aren't heroes to find. Not real heroes. There's the make-believe Marvel comics.
Right.
But, and they're looking for power, and they're looking for authority, and they're looking for someone to believe in. And I said, and you're going to know the truth. You're going to walk in this. I said, but you got to get the teaching. So I gave him the connections. I gave him your business card, and I said, you need to get in touch with Holy Spirit-led ministries. And I said, and you need to Skype. And Michael goes, I know someone who Skypes in Halifax or something. He says, I know what that is. I'm going to Skype. So they were just really excited. It was wonderful. Yeah. I said, man, Lila prayed and we prayed that this trip would be a ministry trip. It wouldn't just be vacation for the sake of vacation.
Yeah.
And every day there were opportunities, weren't there?
And plenty of divine connections.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a quick commercial, then we'll be right back, and you can tell us some more of them. It's exciting. We'll be right back.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
To the Lord on high, God of wonders, early in the morning. I will celebrate the light. When I stumble in the darkness, I will call your name.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Loggie and Holy Spirit-led ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Well, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie, and we have Christine and Dave Waite and Lila Shute. Shut. I'm sorry. I just asked her tonight. I've known her for years. I used to work with her at Yonkers like 15 years ago, but I never knew her last name. So anyhow, so you guys had more divine appointments and more healings when you were out and about in Massachusetts. Is that where you were?
Yes. The people that we met at the church we used to attend, there were some sweet little old ladies that were there. Some of it was sad for us because you see people, and I really, the same thing we've said before, I looked at David and I said, it really does feel now that we've surpassed all of our mentors, the people that have taught us. Yeah, but I felt it for the first time.
Yeah. And it's sad. It's kind of sad,
it's too. It's really disturbing. Right. It breaks your heart. And so I was like, oh, you guys got to get this. You got to get this. I mean, everyone that we ran into, we told them. We prayed for a young man, and he got so touched by the Lord. He was like, when are you coming back? When are you coming back? He wanted to join us. He said, I'm going to watch the website to see when they schedule you, because I definitely want to come. And a dear friend of mine, I saw her, and she was going through the same thing, the warfare. She said, it's tough, it's hard, it's tough, it's hard. And I was like, I don't know, I'm so glad I'm not in that middle ground, the battle middle ground. I just feel like we're marching forward.
Amen.
And I want everybody to march forward with us. And that's what breaks our heart, right? Because, you know, Dave, you know what it feels like. You're building people up, and you're helping them be who they're meant to be. And then you see people who don't necessarily take it. They don't They don't want it, but when you connect with people and they feel the power, and they've been in church for years and years and years doing the same thing over and over again and getting no results, that's hard to see.
Mm-hmm.
But those that we prayed for, we met a woman who was going on a missions trip to Africa.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, why don't you share that? Because you were a witness to that. No, I was actively involved. You witnessed it. You share from your perspective.
She was going to go on a missions trip, and so I said, well, we'll pray for you before you leave. And so I said, Christine, we need to pray for this lady because she's going to go on a missions trip. She says, well, don't tell me what it's about. Don't tell me. I don't need to know. And so Christine started praying, and Christine prayed exactly what the lady needed before she goes on her missions trip, and it was really exciting.
Yeah, she was going to Africa, I believe, and she was going to be working with orphans. But the reason I said, don't tell me anything, is because when you pray for someone and you don't know what their situation is, they'll know it's God.
Yeah.
They will know it's by the Holy Spirit. And so I prayed for her, and the three things I said was, I see you ministering to children, and you're like this, you know, love energy, and they just suck it off you. And I said, there should be no fear, because they just need your attention and your love. And the second thing I said to her was, there's a wall of fire around you to protect you from the witchcraft that goes on in that land and things. There were other things that I was seeing, and there were three things I prayed, and she said, man, you nailed it, because somebody prophesied over me the wall of fire, and then you prayed it for me. And so she had tears in her eyes, and she just said, you know, yeah, I'm going to see the kids and the orphans. And so it meant more to her that we didn't know in advance. And that's important, that you not only get the confirmation that you're getting what you need to get from the Holy Spirit to encourage somebody else, not by knowledge up here, but by the Spirit in your belly. And she was so blown away. She was just hugging everybody and crying, and it was really special. And then the two little ladies, Claire and Olive. Olive had been through so much, and we prayed for her.
Yeah, and it was interesting when we prayed for Olive, and Dave taught me this, that she just couldn't receive. As we started to pray, she just started praying in tongues, and she was going on. And we had to kind of stop her for a minute and tell her, you know, and I told her what Dave said, you know, if you turn on a faucet and water is pouring out of it, is there any way you can shove water back up into the faucet?
We've done that many times.
No. I said, okay, so just receive. Don't pray. Don't just receive what we're giving you.
Yeah.
And when she did, she got hit.
And she was gone. I mean, she was like this. And I was like, I said, Olive. And I couldn't get her attention. I mean, like, she was just in the zone, you know. But I had to get in her ear, and I said, Olive. Just receive. Shh. It took a minute or two for her to train herself not to be active,
right,
but to just be a sponge. And then she started to fall, right?
Yeah.
You had to try and hold her up, because now she's really receiving, and she's like, I thought we were going to have her on the floor. We held her up, but then she was like, wow. So just learning to receive.
Yep.
You know, it's better to give than to receive, but we need receivers out there.
Yeah.
We need receivers.
Well, it seems like when you have somebody who's been in ministry, whether they're a pastor or whatever, they seem to be the hardest ones.
It is.
That's just what we found.
Yeah, it is harder for whatever reason, whether it's the sacred cows or whatever it is, it just seems to be a tougher road to mm-hmm. go than to yep. take somebody who doesn't know anything.
Right.
And, you know, they get healed, they get saved, they get delivered, they get filled with yep. the Holy Ghost, and they're off and running.
Amen. You know? Yep, we have that. And, you know, I think it's just like they're so used to, like you said, to giving. But it's like, you know, if somebody wants to pray for us, pray for us. We'll receive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, amen.
We have no problem at all. We're always giving. Sometimes I actually say, hey, can you guys pray for us? You know? So.
Well, I've been doing that for years. If somebody's prophetic, I walk into a new place, first thing I'll do is I'll grab the most prophetic person there and speak over us. So then they know what heaven said, and now they have to argue with heaven. They don't have to argue with what we're saying.
That's
hey, you're the
awesome.
One that said that. Come out of your mouth.
I'm picking up on that one.
That's
going to do that.
Yeah,
too.
It's
That's
good.
A great tactic.
Well,
it
you
really
guys
is.
Have grown. Was just talking at break. I met you at a year ago on New Year's Eve. Now look at you're doing it. You're
Amen.
Surpassing all your mentors.
Amen.
And I met you guys almost 2 years ago, not quite yet.
Yep.
Look at you've surpassed all your mentors.
Amen. Praise
and I
God.
And I about started weeping. I actually stepped out of the room for a minute because I've seen that and I feel the power of God coming off of you like never
Amen.
Before.
Amen.
Dave went with us for a couple of months and he just went right to 100%.
Yeah, that was yeah, so when many you're, testimonies.
When you're out doing it, that's when you grow. You know, when I'm preaching, it's like God's speaking to me. When I'm preaching, and so I'm growing when I'm preaching, and it, mm-hmm. it's so neat. I love that. And Dave Wade experienced that because he was just getting hit at times when he was up there with Dave teaching.
I thought and, it was kind of funny that
yeah.
he'd sit there and he couldn't talk. Yeah, now you know what I'm talking about. It's hard,
really?
It's hard standing there sometimes because mm-hmm. the power and the manifest presence of God hits you so hard that it's hard to look good while you're still fast.
Yeah. And I found that I've never been much in revelatory gift, but I would get revelation as I was doing the teaching.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly.
And Dave's our new board member.
Yeah.
It's official.
Praise God. Yep.
I want to build a team of people that are all in.
Yep. Amen.
I don't care who you are. I don't care what you've been, where you come from. I just want... Make a decision, you're all in.
Right.
We'll still love you if you ain't. That's not the problem. But we want to build a sending center, equipping station with the right message that gets results.
Amen.
And I want to grow this.
I just have to add, Jason Bragg, he stopped by our house the other day. He did it surprised. He called and he said, hey, where are you guys at? Dave says, we're at home. He goes, really? Okay. And he's just talking for a while, and then we're sitting in the front room, and he pulls up in front of the pitch window, and Dave's like, hey, that's you.
He's got a great big 4x4, four-door Dodge truck.
And with the boat hooked on the back, you know, it's Jason.
And you need, like, a ladder to get into the thing. It's
yes.
so big.
Yes. But we had a great time just sharing things about the Lord and just our experiences, you know. And I just wanted to touch on that because... You know, we haven't got 100% all the time. There's been some meetings that we have, praise God, but we're not all there yet. And that's something that we want to know how to get there. And so we were just talking about that because, you know, there's people that haven't been healed yet, and it really bothers us. It really, you know, the thousands of people that get healed, yeah, great. But the ones that don't just really, they hurt. Because we want to see them all. And so we talked about that because, you know, we've raised the dead. And so why aren't some of them being healed? And if there's somebody that's died, we want to see them come back. We don't want to see people go, you know, especially when it's not their time, when they're young.
Mm-hmm.
We want to get this. One of the things that God did tell me why we were talking about it was that He was really happy with us because we cared that much, you know, that's what we're talking about. What can we do different? How can we do it better? How can we change? What do we need to do? And that he was just really happy with us because that's what our topic of conversation was. And then he stopped back by on the way back. And Saturday night, we were talking again about it because he had a friend of his that has just recently passed. And, you know, it hurts. Mm-hmm. It really hurts. And so one of the things that God told me why we were talking about it at that point in time was that Jason said, you know, I did everything I knew to do. And he didn't see what he wanted to see when it was somebody in the bed that was in a coma. And somebody else said to him, well, then why don't you let God? And it was like,
how?
Just be surrendered. Just release the kingdom. It's not always about what we do. It's just,
you're still in the mental ascent.
Mm-hmm.
And it's when you've finally done all you can do and you stand, that's when God can take over.
There was one time that we were somewhere and I was physically exhausted, and I don't usually get that way very much because, I mean, God gives us plenty of energy. Sometimes I do get tired. I try to rest at times. My husband just goes and goes and goes till he collapses. But he can fall asleep in 2 seconds, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Anyhow. It was a long day. It was about midnight, and we were going to go back to the hotel from where we were staying. And Dave said, "There's one more lady I want you to pray for," and I was just
so happy to do it.
So tired. I was like, "Honey, I'm exhausted," and he's like, "Come on." And so it was like, "Okay," and I'm just like, "Lord, I can't do this anymore." And when I just put my arms around her and gave her a Jesus hug, and it was like this blanket just fell on us, like a cape just fell over the top of both of us. Mm-hmm. And because it wasn't me anymore, but I just stepped into it. I was obedient, and then God took over, you know?
It's exciting, isn't it?
And so that's what we need to do all the time.
Been telling you that.
Is let God take over.
And it really is about letting go. Like, there's times when I've gone to pray for somebody, and because you say you're going to pray or, you know, whatever, release the kingdom,
mm-hmm.
you go to take their hands. They get in position. Do you ever notice that? So they go, they guard themselves, and they put their hands out, and then they're like, and there's a wall. And you can actually feel it. And so I tried to pray for this woman several times, and she just wasn't one. She got into this mental mode of, I don't know, almost militant-like. And I just said, honey, I just need to give you a hug.
Yeah.
And you know what? When I gave her a hug, there was nothing for her to do except receive. And she melted.
Uh-huh.
She got the Holy Ghost that way.
Amen.
So sometimes you can't do the structured thing. You know, Jesus did something different every time that they wrote about, right?
Yeah.
And I think it's because people receive in many different ways. And so if one way isn't working, catch him by surprise. Just hug him. Or
Amen.
Or you can do what Jeff does to me. Go up behind him and go, life!
Can I just share a story about Christine?
Hang on. We got to take a quick commercial. And we'll be back. We'll let you share our things.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are. Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you. What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Logging, Holy Spirit-led ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Hi, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Logie, Christine and Dave White, and Lila Shutt. All right, I finally got it the third time. So, maybe we can play that video quick, Ryan. There's one, Val and his wife, Jean. They were New Year's Eve, and then we'll come back to your story, okay, Lila?
So we can hear.
We had people over for New Year's Eve, and they were there, and one leg was shorter than the other. Okay, there they are.
My name is Val Bariola. This is my wife, Jean, and I'm 62 years old. And tonight, New Year's Eve, I received prayer for my leg to be lengthened, and I've received prayer from many, many others, and nothing's really happened. But tonight, my leg extended and grew out. I have no pain in the back of my knee. I have no pain in my back, or actually anywhere in my body. So I'd like to just give that testimony to the Lord Jesus that He is a miracle-working God, a healing God, and loving God.
Amen. How far do you think it grew out?
At least an inch, because we could never stand this close and be this the same height almost.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I noticed
eye to eye now.
You're standing up straighter too.
Oh, like, yeah, a lot straighter.
You were stood more crooked before.
Yeah, I was in a lot of pain when I came in.
So okay.
I don't have any pain now.
So. Praise God.
And no glasses on.
Yeah, no glasses.
So a lot of different things happened.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Praise God.
Sure. Amen. Praise
Do you have anything else?
Can I tell them about you?
No, that's okay.
Well, that straightened your eyes.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Praise God. All right, well, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, and you guys know that
yes.
couple.
Her, but I know him.
Oh, okay. They came over New Year's Eve. Tim brought them. He knows everybody in Des Moines area, I think.
Yeah.
And then they invited us over to their house on New Year's Day. So we got to go to their house and minister to a bunch of new people that we'd never met before. So that was neat. So then I said, you know, we're doing this DHT training at the end of January in Ankeny. So you guys are welcome to come.
Oh,
and so Dave was telling them all kinds of testimonies. And so they really were interested. And some of them had seen a little bit of this, but not walking in it in the fullness that they can be. So they really were interested in it. And he ran into some sacred cows, of course.
Yeah, we did too.
I told him, I said, I'll answer all your questions as long as you promise me one thing, you won't get mad at me. Well, they lied.
Nice try.
Well, they kind of got mad at us too.
Yeah, that's just kind of par for the course.
But there was a couple that were really hungry. They were street ministers, evangelists. They were getting people healed once in a while.
Yeah.
But they were salvation mainly. But this guy was hungry. I said, I'll ask you. But I said, we spent, 5 hours there?
Oh, six? Longer than that. I think we got there about 2:30 or so, and we left about
midnight. We're going to leave at 11. Suburban. New
That's
battery.
That's how we are, you know.
So the guy goes around the block to come around to jump start us because it's tight parking. And as he's turning the corner, he can't steer no more. And he goes over and slides into the curb. What's wrong with this guy? He tries to back up, and he's spinning. He gets up to jump, and we look, and the front tire is off the rim.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, wow. We had a fun night.
So then we had to jump the Suburban. Then we got it backed away so we could change it. Now it's below zero and windy.
Yeah.
And we're not prepared for that because we all dressed up to come there. So we're trying to use what we had. And it's a pickup, so we got to get the tire out from underneath the snow in the back.
We run in
and warm up, and we come back, and then his car won't start. So I have to jump him off the one he jumped. So it's after midnight before we got out of there finally.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, and somebody, I think it was Jean, she's like, well, Satan just didn't like it, what you guys were doing tonight, did
That's
he?
That's right.
Well, the guy that jumped us, he comes up and says, you know me. I couldn't place him. And, you know, 5 hours later, I said, you had a swelled up abscess tooth at the House of Prayer a couple years ago, and I just reached up and put my hand on you, and instantly you got healed. Yep, told you you'd know me.
Amen.
So he knew it was a real deal. He never came back, and so that's why he was asking questions, because he wanted to know, because they were taught the opposite of what the Bible really says.
Mm-hmm.
It sounds good. It sounds religious. And I don't remember, was it Vic? Started with a V.
Vince.
He was into a lot of different industries. And I said, you know all the scriptures, but you got them mixed all together. You got the Old Covenant, sacred cow stuff that we don't live under. And so I didn't tell you anything new. All I'm doing is say, if you want to be a son, act and use the son scriptures. Don't use the Old Covenant, baby. Yeah, you're right. He was so excited. And then there was a couple cows he really didn't. I said, I'll demonstrate it. And you know me, I'm kind of sneaky. I walk up and just blast it. I'm in power of God. See? I didn't have to go. I've never fasted. I didn't have to pray. I've been talking to you. You've seen me. But I know how to release the kingdom.
Well, you and I talked about it just last week when we talked about the fact that, I forget, maybe it was on the phone, that the Gentiles, okay, the Jews in the Old Testament, they were the only ones under the law. The Gentiles were not under the law.
Ever.
We are Gentiles.
We put ourselves under it.
And right. We put ourselves under the law.
Yeah, so let's not.
And what's the Bible say about that?
Yeah.
You'll be under a curse of the law if you don't fulfill all of it. So exactly. Why even try?
You'll be falling asleep. And
Amen. So we're not going to.
Yeah.
But I got to make a couple announcements, and we have to pray. We're running out of time. This has gone really fast, and we're not going to get through everything. But, Lord, help us to get out the important stuff.
We got one important one first. We got the text from the baby was dead. The lady was dead. We start our Sunday service with a dead lady.
Yes.
So we declare, James preaches, Norma sings, and before it's over, Zoe says, she's up talking.
Praise God.
The dead lady's up talking. Praise Pretty good God. For church, sir. We declare it over there, and Amen. We just stood on it.
Praise God.
Amen. So I just wanted to announce, too, that in the end of this month is January. We'll have a DHT in Ankeny, Iowa. And then in February, we'll be in Texas, Austin, doing a DHT. And then in March, we'll be back in Washington doing a DHT. So check out our website for you know, if you're close by, and if you're on the way there, we usually drive because we take all of our equipment. So maybe we can stop on the way there or on the way back. Look where Iowa is and where we're headed and see what we can fit in. You know, we like to stop at different places and have meetings. And sometimes we just pray because somebody's in the hospital and they need to be healed. So praise God. God just makes these divine appointments and makes them fit. Do you want to tell your quick story? We got to pray.
We were having a bad weather, and Dave and Christine were in the front seat. And Dave says, Lila, pray for Christine. She's getting nervous and fearful. So I just prayed the fire of God go on over you, and she went like this and got blasted. And then he says, and I prayed for peace on her head. And I said, how was that? I go, I've been wanting to try this the whole time. Dave's been saying the fire of God go on you. And so I tried it, and Christine just got blasted.
Well, you know where I got that from.
Dave. I picked it up from James.
It works.
Praise
it
works. God. Yeah, it sure does. Well, we got to pray. There's so many of us. We'll just let you three.
Yeah, you three do.
Christine, why don't you start out? Dave, you jump in, and then you can finish up. Whatever the Holy Spirit puts on your heart to pray for, And add Terry in your prayers and add Cheryl. So,
Father, we thank you for every mother out there, every woman who is pregnant, and especially for our friend Nina right now.
Amen.
Father, that they will carry those babies to full term.
Yes.
Those babies will be whole. They will be full. They will be intelligent. We come against every illness that can possibly come against those babies, and we do not allow ADHD, anything missing, anything lacking, Down syndrome. We just come against all of that, and we say, every baby, you be whole, and you be intelligent, and you have nothing missing and nothing broken, and health for the mothers as well.
Amen. Supernatural childbirth.
Amen.
Amen.
No pain. That's what you mean, right?
Yes.
Amen. Childbirth with no pain in Jesus' name.
Amen. I just pray for this ministry that it will grow, that as we touch lives, that this will just spread like wildfire. I just believe in my heart that this is the gospel of the kingdom that Jesus preached, and this is what needs to be done. We need to heal the sick, set the captives free, get them saved, get them filled with the Holy Spirit. And the people out there today are just suffering and dying. They need this. They need the kingdom of heaven in their life. And so I just pray that this ministry will advance in just a mighty way as we go forth across this country.
Father, I just thank you for the opportunity to pray right now. I just pray for this ministry to go forth, that your kingdom would go forth over this earth, Lord God, and you use us as vessels and put us where you want us when you need us, Lord. And we just thank you for everyone here. We thank you for their health, their safety. We thank you for all the things you've done for us. And we thank you that you are a mighty God, and we praise you for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
And we just lift up Terrell and Sherry and just speak life and light into them both in Jesus' name.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
That they be healed and whole now in Jesus' name.
And I would pray for unity in the body of Christ, that all those that are out there that need to get a hold of the word rightly divided, that their eyes would be open, their hearts would be open, they would receive, their ears would be open, and they would see the truth and the light, and they would bear witness, and the Holy Spirit would activate in them, and that they would come to the fullness and understand who they are as sons of Christ and get a hold of this teaching and stand up so that all the world will be full of the sons of men. The sons of God have to come to the fullness. They have to rise up. And we need that in the whole earth, Lord. And so send us, but help us make disciples. We want to see disciples everywhere we go, not just here in this country, but around the world.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, if you're a Christian, you can lay hands on the sick. You have Jesus inside of you. You don't need any special anointing. You don't need to go to college. Just let Jesus out. And, you know, there's times when I was a child that I did this. I didn't know what I was doing. But God used me even back then. And so he's going to use you now if you just let him. But come to one of these trainings. Crib Lake has them in Texas. Come to one of these trainings. Get trained up. Walk in this. Watch it online. Divine Healing Technician Training online. Watch the New Man series so you can just know who you really are in Christ. And if you have a group, if you're a pastor, give us a call. That's our website. And my phone number is 515-229-0111. Can you put that out there, Ryan? 515-229-0111. We want to see everybody walking in this. If all the Christians were healed and whole, you know what? The heathens would come into the church to get it too. They'd be like, what's different about them? What do they have that I don't have?
It's affordable health care.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I just have to tell you a quick story too. I was in the grocery store with my youngest the other day. And there was a pregnant lady. And so I'm like, I'll catch up with you, honey. Because I want to pray for all these pregnant ladies so they have painless childbirth, that they have supernatural childbirth, that that they know when they're in labor, but they don't have pain. And most of all, I want to pray for those babies that they're whole and healthy. And God has shown me that there's times when that baby's not healthy. And I laid hands on them, and they've been healed. And so that's pretty cool. Mm. And I pray for them that the Holy Spirit touches them, too, from the inside out. So they both have it in Jesus' name. And then as I was praying for one, another pregnant lady walked by. And it's like, oh, no. I got to get this one done first. And my daughter was watching me. And she's like, Mom, you just, like, chase them down, don't you?
That's the boldness. You got to be bold when you see the need.
And it's like, you know what? If there's something wrong with that baby, I want to lay hands on that mom. I want that baby to be healthy.
And your daughter actually did that. She was declaring over a pickup or a truck.
Oh, yeah. She said, it's going to work.
There you go. They learn, don't they?
Yeah.
And she went no part of this ever.
No, they do learn.
And she's doing it, even though she says she doesn't want...
Yeah, she doesn't want you to know.
My car is going to start. I'm declaring that.
Oh, that's cool.
Excellent.
Did you guys have some more stories? We got about a minute and a half left.
I'll just share a cute one. When my son was little, you know, we were learning the whole declaration thing and learning to give praise and thanks to God. I want to thank God today for everything that he's done, for raising that man out of a coma, and for all the lives that are saved and that will be saved and raised up and made better on the earth. But my son, you know, they do learn from what you do and how you demonstrate. And I just remember him standing in the kitchen as a little guy, and he said, oh, praise God, the spoons are clean. Just cracked me up. You can be thankful for anything.
Oh, that's good. I like
where
that.
Where I grew up, that was an old farmhouse where you had mice. You always checked.
Oh, yeah.
Because you never knew.
Oh, no. Well, I want to thank you guys for being on the show, Lila.
Hey, if anybody wants to advertise on here, give us a call, too. We've had 35,000-plus viewers each quarter.
Amen.
So if you know anybody that wants to advertise, get their message out, wants to help sponsor us for the show.
Amen. Yep. We'll put it on here, and people will see. As long as that lines up with our programming.
And everybody say... The name of the show, I Believe in Miracles.
We sure do. I just want to thank Ryan, our producer. He does a great job keeping up with all that we do. I know we're kind of demanding.
He's going to be on next week with some testimonies.
Thank you. And I want to thank Christine and Dave and for all you guys do. You guys are a blessing. And Michael, he does our website. He makes us look really good. Thank you, Jesus. Bless him, Lord. Mm-hmm. And for all of our team. So, but most of all, we want to thank God because he's the one that makes it all happen. So thank you, God. See you next week. Same time, same place.
You hold my you